Homestead, the winning karting team, Mario Andretti, and the great Clay Regazzoni driving separate karts because Regazzoni lost the use of his legs in a racing accident, drove a hand-controlled kart. Congratulations to Clay and Mario. Right now, Mario's boy, Michael, leads the way over defending FedEx Championship Series title holder, Alex Zanardi. Restart, lap 140, 10 to go. Make that 11 to go, including this lap. Next time by, we'll have 10 laps to go, and Andretti driving away from Zanardi on the backstretch. What a jump for Michael Andretti, who has been able to demonstrate tremendous acceleration all day long, Danny.
I don't know whether it's the Goodyear tires or his car just comes to life on those restarts and pulls away, and that's something that we've normally seen from Alex Zanardi. And he doesn't appear to be able to match Michael's speed today.
That Ford is basically a three-year-old engine design, but it does have many, many updates for this year. New heads, a new bottom end, the crankshaft, conrods, bearings, and pistons. It must be pumping out well in excess of 800 horsepower. And Michael Andretti right now is working it. 21 cars remain running with 9 laps to go now for Michael Andretti, looking for his series-leading 37th career victory. Last lap, 201 miles an hour.
He's not coming out of the throttle as much as he was early on. You can hear that, the throttle. What, listen to him go in the corner.
There is his car owner, Paul Newman, standing behind the team. Look at that steering input for Michael Andretti. Smooth, no handling problem at all. As Ed Nathman and the team talk Michael Andretti home on the backstretch through turns 3 and 4. Traffic ahead. Omega timing shows Andretti more than a second and a half up on Zanardi. The bright yellow Yolt Lola of Art Meyer just ahead. Tip of the helmet to that crew. That car had no oval track testing when they came here this weekend with two new models. Lola trying to get back.
Now see what's happened with Art Meyer. He held up Zanardi, and look at this. Greg Moore making a dive down the inside. That was all because Alex Zanardi had to lift off a little bit and go around the outside turn 4.
Let me get back to a question I was going to ask you earlier, Danny. So in a sports car race, when I both attended at Daytona earlier this year, they told the guys to stay low on the banking if you were being overtaken. Here, guys are going up to let the faster cars come by underneath them. You see some cars into the wall as a result.
Well, they let him go by on the inside going into the corner, but you saw right there he stayed down on the outside. The problem is Alex Zanardi has to back off a little bit just to get around it. He just can't hold the throttle down. It's a little bit too slippery out in that area. He breathes it just enough to allow Brett Moore to slingshot off of turn 4 and pass him down the front straight.
Moore's gained a little bit. Watch Moore. He got 3 laps to go. Moore's gaining.
Earlier, Ed Nathman told Michael Andretti, the only guy who can run with you is Moore. And there is Greg Moore, our pole sitter, the man who has demonstrated by far more speed than anyone else thus far this weekend. But he has his work cut out for him now, trying to run down Andretti. Two to go. Traffic ahead for Michael Andretti. That's Jimmy Vassar directly ahead. Michael closing rapidly. And Moore closing behind Andretti. White flag this time by.
Bring it home, Michael.
What else can you say with a mile and a half to go for Michael Andretti? Check up, that was Father Mario telling Michael, bring it home. There is Moore, who is right there working traffic. Moore absolutely flying through three and four. They'll come off the turn, nose to tail. Greg Moore looking for a way by. He's within a car length, but he won't get it done. Michael Andretti comes through.
Very good. Very good.
What a finish. Greg Moore gave it all. He played the traffic just perfectly. He just came up just short.
Very good, Michael. Very good. Made it close.
And a chuckle. Yeah, did you hear his voice breaking there? He almost played it too conservatively.
Ed Nathman in the white hat. Welcome back to Newman Haas Racing for Ed Nathman. He and Michael Andretti, victory. Greg Moore lit the afterburner on that last lap and closed right.
They're in the victory circle, Michael. Hey, Steve, 10 turns and turn left there. The golf cart, my toolbox, please, and take it to sex.
Well, I guess we're going to have to rename this Miami-Dade Homestead Motorsports Complex, Swift Central. 2 years, two races, two wins for the Swift chassis. Michael Andretti's 37th. The third time in the last 5 years that Michael has won the season opener. Jack Arute is down in victory lane. Take it away, Jack.
There's nothing that can be said right now. Just listen to the enjoyment of the crew and fans as Michael Andretti scores his first victory of 1998. Well, Michael, it was 12 months before you came back to victory lane, but you came back and you knew right where to go. But, boy, he ran the string awfully tight there in the last lap.
Yeah, I really played a conservative the last two laps and almost backfired. But, you know, we pretty much had it under control, but I was just maybe a little too careful there and almost stopped. But we made it, and it already happened.
Now, you just made it, I'll tell you what. But Ed Nathman comes up here. Listen to this.
Welcome back.
Welcome back, Nathman. You came from the IRL back to kart, and you really kept this kid really cool all day.
AJ Foyt taught me a few things, you know.
Carl Haas, let me ask you one thing, though, Michael. You know, there's a new attitude with you. You can see it. We've seen it at spring training. We've seen it all year. Where'd it come from?
Oh, I don't know. I have a lot of great things happen in my personal life, and the racing team has turned around. The car's a lot better. I think we're going to be a lot more competitive. The tire situation's much better, so I have a lot more confidence from all of that. You know, it's just it's a great year so far, and we got to keep it going now and not wait another 12 months to do this.
Is the Swift up to the task this year? There were some problems, you know. We thought it was going to be great last year.
It's absolutely up to the task. You know, I think they did a great job over the winter to make a better car, and along with Goodyear, they've done a great job. The tires were perfect today, and, you know, everything was just great.
Can it get any better?
No. Yeah, it can. We'll win the next one.
Guys.